Good morning. My name is Gary Aho. I'm a veteran of the oil shale industry, been working on a project here in Uinta County for 35 years. And I'm going to talk about where we are at today. My presentation is designed for a little longer time slot than I've got, so I'm going to be flying through some slides this morning. What I want to talk about, first of all, is oil shale, the oil demand, where we are today. Talk a little bit about the company I'm now working for, which is Enefit American Oil Company, a new neighbor here in Vernal. We just opened an office out of Utah State University Bingham Center, and I'm the Vice President of Operations in that office. I'm also going to talk about Enefit's experience in producing shale oil in the country of Estonia, in Northern Europe, and the new technology they're developing and putting into production in that country, that same technology we plan to bring here to the United States to build an oil shale project south of Vernal that'll eventually produce 50,000 barrels per day by 2024. What we're faced with in the world today, of course, as you all know, we're faced with increasing oil prices. And the question's always been, why isn't oil shale happening? And it's always part of it's been a question of the price that it takes to produce it. And the other question's always been a question of technology. Is the technology ready? And I only want to address those two issues today. We're looking at what the price of oil is going to be going forward. And of course, no one can project what that's going to be. There's estimates as high as $200 per barrel by 2030, some low estimates of even as low as 50. And we think our hurdle price for production of shale oil here in the Uinta Basin with our technology is roughly $70 per barrel. We look at this project as being economic and we're moving forward. One of the things that we're faced with in the world scene is the price of producing conventional oil continues to increase. And as world demand for oil increases, we're looking at the nations or the world consuming about 100 million barrels per day by the year 2030. We're currently at a level of 80 million barrels per day. So as the world population grows and the economies of foreign countries evolve, the demand for oil is going to increase. And despite our efforts to produce and displace some of this with electricity generated by solar or wind, that doesn't fuel our automobiles, it doesn't fly our airplanes, and it doesn't fuel our trains. So the demand for oil is going to continue to grow. And what we're finding out is that the development or the discovery and the production of conventional oils continue to increase. Some of the deep water stuff off of Mexico now, they're estimated costing about $75 per barrel to explore, develop, and produce. One of the things as we get to the level of 100 million barrels per day, this right column with the 2030, the question becomes, where's that oil going to come from? And we're seeing an increasing amount of that oil eventually coming from unconventional hydrocarbon resources, such as shale oil, heavy oil, and the bitumens, which is basically our oil sands here in Utah. The oil shale portion of this, the United States of America has by far the largest resources of oil shale anywhere in the world. And the greatest concentrations are right here in eastern Utah, western Colorado, and southern part of Wyoming. This country controls roughly 72% of the world's oil shale resources. And you'll notice the country near the bottom is the country of Estonia, which I'm going to talk about briefly. That country controls a small amount of the world's resources of oil shale, but it is their primary natural resource in that country. And they've been producing oil shale for over 100 years, burning it in their power plants and producing oil. And so we're looking at bringing their technology and experience to the United States. I'm going to give you a little introduction of the company. It is the nationally owned energy company of the country of Estonia. And if you realize that the country of Estonia is a small country with only a population of about 1.3 million people, they have made their largest international investment, that nation has, in Uinta County, Utah. This is a major move for that country to come and invest in a foreign nation come to the state of Utah, and as they looked at their opportunities around the world for oil shale, they realized very suddenly that not only did Uinta County have the resource, the business climate was right. And this county and this state have warmly welcomed the people from Estonia. They are the largest employer in the nation, SD Energy, which is a national energy company. They have roughly 7,500 employees. They're a vertically integrated company that does their own mining of oil shale. They have four mines operating in the country now. Two of them are underground, two surface. They produce roughly 17 million tons per year of shale, which is a large mining operation. They generate 2.3 million megawatts of power by burning shale directly. They're the largest consumer, largest producer of shale in the world. They also have been producing shale oil for roughly 50 years. They have two retorts operating in that country right now. They call them the Enefit 140 units. Those have been operating for over 30 years. They produce roughly a million barrels per year of shale oil right now. And they're in the process of ramping that up. But what they're doing is they've taken their technology and looking for international opportunities. They've got a project going in Turkey, but their big project right now that they're looking at is the one right here in Uinta County. In the country of Estonia, like I mentioned, they've been producing shale oil for over 30 years with the two Enefit 140 units, and they're expanding production. Right now, they're building a brand new Enefit 280, which is a new retort in that country. The county commissioners and Kevin were over there to look at, Kevin Van Tassel toured that new operation, saw the construction. Their goals in the country of Estonia, you see they're right now at just over a million barrels per year. Their objective is to get up to roughly 7 million barrels per day by 2016, and then include an upgrader in that where they're going to produce finished products and refinery-ready products. So they're expanding. These are some photographs of the new plant that's under construction in Estonia right now. They expect to have that operational by the year 2012, and that unit will be their new showplace retort. They are teamed up with a company called Odatech, which is a Finnish-German company that is one of the leading pyroprocessing companies in the world. And so Estonians and the Finnish and the Germans have joined together forces to develop the technology, the new state-of-the-art technology. Right now, one of the unique things about this retort is the fact that it uses all of the shale that we mine. What I'm getting at is that the process is a horizontal rotary kiln system. We put the shale in one end, it goes through the pyrolysis process. We produce shale oil and high BTU off gases. But then they take the shale that comes out of the retort, which still has some residual carbon and BTUs on it. They go to a fluidized bed combustor, which burns that residual carbon off the shale. So what goes to the waste pile, we call ash, is carbon-free, and it is environmentally acceptable, EPA-approved waste material. They use all of the energy in the rock, so they produce not only oil, but also natural gas, and then they take that excess heat and produce electricity. So they will be a net producer of electricity, and they will not have to consume outside sources of energy once the system gets up to temperature. It uses some of that waste heat goes back into the retort as a source of energy. So it uses what we call a solids-to-solids heat transfer. It's a very efficient system. The new unit they're building, of course, is going to have to meet all of the European Union environmental requirements. And the retort itself, of course, does not use any water. We're a low water consumer. We do use some water for mining and dust control, heat control. But anyhow, we believe that the new technology will be an environmentally superior unit for here in the Uinta Basin. And as I mentioned, the Estonians have teamed up with Odatech, which is one of the leading technology companies in the world in the mining and mineral processing industry. And the Estonians, one of the things, like I said, they've got over 100 years of experience. This is a large corporation, the largest company in the country of Estonia. So coming to the United States, it's not like they're an upstart company, is the point I'm trying to make. They've been mining shale for 100 years. They've been in this business for a long time. These folks have got an extremely strong work ethic, as those of us that have been working with them can attest to. These people didn't make this investment to fail. They made a national investment, a national commitment to Uinta County. They're coming here to get this project up and operating. The project we have here in Uinta County, this is just an overview of our land position. We've got roughly 30,000 acres, a resource of about 2.6 billion barrels, and a land package that consists of the largest private holdings in the state of Utah, largest private oil shale holding block. We also have the White River Mine RD&D lease, which, if any of you are familiar with the White River Mine, it's down south of Bonanza. It was developed during the 1970s. I was part of that original team. I hate to say I'm that old, but I was part of that original team that developed that mine. And so I've got a long history with that property. I also put together this private land position when I was a president of Cliff Sinfield Corporation. So I'm intimately familiar with the property. We're working with CITLA. We've had a lot of meetings with the BLM because we have the White River Mine. And our project development is going to be taking place initially east of the ghost town of Watson down there, which is one of the original Gilsonite operations. This is our schedule for development. Starting in 2011 on the left, we've got 4 to 6 years of permitting and environmental baseline studies. We're just getting ready to kick off a major drilling project down there. In the next 2 weeks, we're doing additional resource assessment. One of the things we're doing this fall is collecting 12 tons of 6-inch diameter oil shale core to put together a shipment that's going to be sent over to Frankfurt, Germany for bench scale testing in the next year. What they've done is taken the retort they're building in Estonia and simulated it in the Frankfurt Research Center. So first of all, we're going to be doing bench scale testing, and then the next year we'll be doing a pilot plant. They're building a new pilot plant in Frankfurt, so we'll be shipping perhaps as much as 100 tons of shale over there in 2013. But anyhow, we would start construction roughly in 2017. The first 25,000 barrels of production would come on stream about 2020. And we'd run that for a year and then start the construction of our next 25,000 barrel per day plant with the objective of, by 2024, reaching full production of 50,000 barrels per day. And just to give you some sort of an idea of what that entails, I mean, this is a huge construction project. We're talking roughly at least a $4 billion investment. The permanent workforce, when we get out there at the year 2024, will be roughly 1,900 to 2,000 permanent employees. This project would then run for 40 years or longer. One of the nice things about this, for the county at least, in terms of a stable employment base, is that people hire on. You take a young fellow getting out of high school or college, could go to work at this operation and work there for 40 years straight or 30 years straight, whatever, and retire. There's a stable employer, and I think that's crucial for the job base here. And if you think about the fact that you got 1,900 to 2,000 employees, and you look at their families and the services industries and the ancillary industries, we look at this as being a supporting of roughly 8,000 employees here in the county. And not only does that bring in people, but it creates steady jobs, of course, a huge tax base for the country, for the county and the state. Again, we're going to be looking at surface and underground mining. I'm not going to get into too much on this, but we will be producing crude shale on site. We'll also have an upgrader on site, which means that we will produce a refinery-ready product with the additional objective of pipelining that into Salt Lake City to the refineries there. We're looking at other markets as well. And I think I'm not going to get into the flow sheet for the plant, but basically one of the things that this project does, and of course what we're all trying to do, is reduce our dependence on foreign oil. We're looking at improving the balance of trade in this country. Employment, of course, is a big part of what we're looking at doing, and of course the tax basis for the county and the state. So that's pretty much my presentation. Again, for myself at least, and for my associates from Estonia, we're really pleased to be here. in Uinta County. I'm pleased to be working in Utah. I've been trying to get shale projects going in the state of Colorado for 30 years as well. Utah's a place to be. I concluded that long ago. And so we're glad to be here. Thank you.